Hey, Don here. Okay. Well, I've got my followed up on my previous video where I discovered that my 6-way cord was messed up. Let me get it. One of the male plugs there has just been burned from high resistance for some reason, and then rusted because it's evidently happened over time. You know, once it's something's been heated up like that, it'll rust real easy. So you can see the other one's real shiny and new looking. And when something gets overheated, it'll rust real easy. Now, it's kind of odd being in the living room that it would get enough more. There's moisture in the air though, so it'll do it. Why that particular leg heated up like that, I don't know. It's being used, you know, to send power. This thing is, about 6 foot, the cord on it's about 6 foot long. And anyway, the only good place we have to put our microwave is right kind of around in the, what used to be the little dining nook next to the kitchen, but there's no plug in that area. And the other plugs, there's too many things in the kitchen. You know, you can't put it on any of the ones in the kitchen. It's too much draw. It'll flip the breaker. So for probably 20 years, we've had either a big extension cord, or this thing is at least 10, 15 years old. I don't even remember anymore. Worked fine until, don't know when it started giving trouble now. That's telling me that that's been a while. So, the other day we discovered, you know, I was in there cooking something in our Kenmore microwave that's about a year old. That's been aggravating ever since we got it. It was always kicking down into a lower heat automatically, lower heat range, and it wouldn't cook your food right. It'd burn the outsides in the middle, would be cold, which was the complaint I saw over and over again on their reviews. After Mom went and bought it at the store without even doing any research, I hadn't been feeling good, and I didn't when the other one went out. And she went down, just went down and got one. So I just decided, you know, I mean, this thing had not kicked off or anything. It's a 6-way with the built-in breaker and everything, no kicking off. The only thing we knew was that cord on the plug. This is what it is right here. It's you know, not completely super heavy duty, but it's heavy enough that it's worked all these years. It's not a small, real small cable. Let's see, 15 amp, 125 volts, so it's a 15 amp. You know, it's not a 20 amp or anything like that, but it has worked fine, and microwaves work on 15 amps. So it wasn't an issue until some point. I don't know if it was this Sears microwave now, I can't say, or if it was the old one before we had got it used. It lasted about 5 years, but it finally started acting up and got to where it didn't want to heat right, and then it, you know, wouldn't cook the food, and it was making a bad smell in itself. But what we, well, that night, whenever it was, they, this is the plug. I've already replaced it with a new one. This is the one that got burnt, and that's what it was plugged into via this. See, our house doesn't have ground, and so we had to use this ground lift. And I've cleaned it up. It was burnt just like that, looking about like that other one. But you can see where it's shiny, dark in the middle and shiny on the edges. One side was burnt, and so when you get a lot of resistance, you get heat, and it starts heating it up. And see, then after we bought a new microwave, because I didn't really inspect that. I just didn't expect anything to be wrong with it. It hadn't clicked off, you know, it hadn't tripped the breaker or anything. And I've seen this kind of thing happen before, you know, and usually the cord itself, as long as it's not melted anyway. See, that was melted right in there, but I didn't pull this off. Didn't really dawn on me until after we got the new one, and I had moved it to this plug. And actually, I was going to bed, and you know, everybody else was in there cooking, and I was getting ready for bed, and I came back, and they was talking, and I could tell something was going on, and I could smell the electric, burn electric smell. And so that's, it was starting to burn that one. And we thought that microwave, something wrong with it, but then it hit me. I thought, man, I got to go start checking into all that. I was already planning on replacing the plug, this plug, but I didn't expect the microwave to come so soon. Amazon shipped it really quick. It was supposed to be here Monday, and this is Sunday. We got it yesterday. So that's what they were saying on their stuff, but you know, you never know for sure. It could be a little faster, a little slower. But I have had this for years. It's a brand new heavy duty male replacement receptacle, replacement plug. I think it's, let's see what it might be rated at. I'm not sure. 25 volt, 15 amp. It's just 15 amp. It looks like it can handle 20 amps just because it's so big. But it's a right angle, which will actually be good. You know, you plug it in there and the cord will be going down instead of out. So it won't get bumped into and stuff. And because I'm pretty sure the rest of this is fine, I'm just going to cut it. I'll start right here and then I may cut a little more off. If any of the wire looks the slightest bit damaged or anything, I will. But let me get my cutters out. And my previous video shows replacing the plug and all that stuff. And so now this is the next step. And if I have any trouble with this, I will just, you know, get a new one. But right now I'd just like to get, if I can, you know, there's no point in buying a new one if you don't need one. Be able to tell if it doesn't work right, I'll know pretty quickly. And I'm trying to make sure I know where my camera's pointed. Don't have a whole lot of workspace here, but with that, I usually don't like to just cut things off and destroy them, but No reason to save that, because there's no telling what damage is done up inside of there. I could probably pull that out of there and see. Ah! No, that's going to take some real work. I might be able to pull it out if I put it in a vise or something, you know, put this part in a vise, but there's no point in it. I could have sanded those, but I didn't know what might have happened to the wires if they'd have been overheated and they had built up resistance from the overheating. So that's a good way to find it. Get my some knife here. How much am I gonna need? Let's get this opened up and see. Tools here now. I had to move some stuff around just to be able to get to my tools. This is a very different one than what you see real often. Okay, so I'm not even on the camera, am I? So let me lay something. I'm gonna lay this here. Whoops. It's hard to, I have some paper. Okay, there we go. My camera's not aiming where I thought it was at all. So, I'm gonna put that. I have paper that was already just laying here. I thought, well, I didn't think it looked so good in the video. Yeah, that paper will help me tell where to be. Otherwise, I'll spend the whole video being off the camera, won't I? Okay, now, I thought that I could handle it, but I ran into the desk with my knee. That hurts. Okay, I've got my drink over there, and I gotta move it. I can't work with that there. Got my phone, my other phone there, in case I wanted to do close. In case I wanted to do any close-ups, but it's pretty close, so just kind of leave things as they are. And that cable looks just fine to me. That wire, it's not real big. It's probably 10 gauge. It's not. I don't think it's even 12 gauge. But it has worked good for many years, so I'm not gonna. Oh, where's that thing? Got all sidetracked. I want to get it apart. There we go. So there it is. I'd had it apart before. I'm sure. So attach all my leads to it. Okay. Yeah, I want to stick my wires up through there. Attach my leads to it. And then you just put it back. Okay. Yeah. And I made the ground on the bottom, so that'll be just right. And that's why I got it. I'm going to put it through there right now so I don't forget later. Let's go ahead and do it like that. Pull it on down. Now, how much do I need? I don't need on down to about right. Yeah. I don't want too far. Well, you got to be able to wrap it around. So, yeah, about where my thumb is. I have a special tool. I don't know if it would work on that or not. I'm going to try it. I have a special wire. What is it, though? I have a special tool. And I don't remember what it's called. Back in 2000. Back in 2000, I had a job for about a year installing telco equipment, and I learned about some new tools. I did building maintenance, electrical work, and all kinds of stuff since 1975 on and off, but I had never seen one of those. Sometimes it works really good, sometimes it doesn't, but it's got a blade in there, and it'll just it will often just do just the right depth, and you when it works right, you can just, a lot of times you can just pull the wire off. Didn't really work right. I'll try to go in there just lightly with my. This knife is a. This is a. Electrician's knife. That we used a lot. Did a lot of cable stripping. So all the nice tools you can get are helpful when you're. I was installing wiring. I installed like 26 pair wire lot. Did a lot. Actually, this was really good on. Couldn't really, you'd go through by accident with that. That other thing would do that 26 pair telephone wire pretty good, but this is a little bit heavier insulation, but you don't want to cut all the way through your other insulation, you know. But anyway, the this is good for they used negative 48 volt DC batteries, huge batteries for backup power for the telephone system. You have to learn a lot of neat stuff doing that. And this in telephone company central offices is where I was working. That's what they call them. And anyway, yeah, these wires are just pristine. Right there, when you know, even though I cut it right there, close to the. I have a nice little. One of those too. All my life I never had any of that cool stuff. I just used a utility knife until I got that job, and then I realized just how much I'd been missing all those cool tools. Look at that. So, I don't know if that's deep long enough or not. Maybe a little more. Where is it? Gotta be careful. So many wires. Uh-oh, did that go up? Yeah, it went up in the keyboard, and we don't want it up in there. I've got these old computers out here because when I'm working, I just couldn't resist setting them up. I had them when I'm working out here on the car or something, and I need to, or anything, and I need to look something up, I can turn them on and look it up. But this was supposedly going to be a work desk bench, and instead it's a computer desk. One of my neighbors was doing remodel, and they put it out on the curb. And it was a built-in desk. It's made out of ash plywood and ash hardwood. And it's really nicer than the one I've got. The one I've got in my room is a freaking particle board with paper on it. But I did make, I had made some cabinets for the bathroom, and I did make a kind of a mouse table, I'll say, with shelves in it that goes under my right, where my right arm can rest on it and work my mouse. Saves me a lot of, makes it a lot more ergonomic, let's put it that way. But it saves me a lot of pain in my arm and elbow. But anyway, this one's just a straight desk, and it had three drawers, but two of them, actually, I saw those first. The two drawers were sitting out there, and I thought, oh, look at that, ash fronts. They were taken, broken. But I used to be a cabinet builder, too, back in the 80s, so one of the several different things I've done over the years. And so I knew how to fix them, but I thought, well, I don't need any broken drawers. And then a few days later, they put this desk out. Like, stupid, should have got that. Well, getting was good. So anyway, I didn't. So, let's see, ground. I'm going to put the ground on there first. Boy, that's kind of hard to get to. Let's see. Already backed off. I just need to figure out how I'm going to make sure I'm still recording. Yep. If I'm talking to myself for no reason, it's no fun. Yeah, there we go. Put my knee on that. There's a box under my desk, which is really in my way as a toolbox, but it also can be handy. I'm using it to keep stuff from falling. Okay, so how am I going to do this? Yeah, I've already got it threaded through over there. Ah! I wasn't paying good attention. These are not the kind you have to wrap around. You can stick them down in there and then tighten it down. That's why it looks so funny. Ow! But this one's not actually seem to be doing right. None of them are. Huh. No, wait, maybe they are the kind you have to try. Depends on what mood it's in, looks like. I have to be able to see my work. I can't just always show and tell. Okay, so. And I don't see like very good like I used to. So, what I'm not understanding is, how strange. So if it's out all the way, there. Now, I don't know if I'm really showing it to the camera that well or not, but I'm trying. It's, you can just stick the wire down in there and tighten that down on it. There we go. What's this other one doing? I don't want to leave that on. It'll run my battery down. There we go. Oh, okay. Just depends on which way it's leaning. So, I didn't need those so long after all. I was making them long enough to maybe I'll put one of these other ones in first. Those are actually the same size. You know how some of them are polarized, but really, and it's such a silly thing because polarization is going to be lost 100 times over. Depends on how, you know, your six ways are wired, the house is wired. The only way that polarization can be kept is if you, it's within the device. But now, see, that's too long. No way you can wrap it around. So now I'm gonna have to cut it off. That's alright, no big deal. Let's see. Just kind of doing one at a time, I guess. do it over here. I was going to do it on the, well, I should do it on the paper, then it'd be easier to, nah, I don't want it in my way while I'm working. There we go. Oops, I didn't go all the way through. Now it's probably too short. Cut it off 3 times, it's still too short. Okay, so. This is a bit different than any I've really ever had. But it's actually, it's so much easier that it's got me thrown off. I kind of remember that I bought it. I already knew, you know, that it was going to be pretty cool. I bought it thinking, man, I like that design. But I've had it for, I believe I got it, I was talking about doing that work in 2000. Well, I bought it before then, I'm pretty sure. Or right around that time. Yeah, I don't want those sticking out that far. But these wires, I was worried about them. Yeah, I wouldn't cut this one off too. These wires, I was worried about them being heated up and, you know, damaged, getting too much. Well, I cut that black one too much, I think. Too much resistance. No, I think it's going to be all right. Okay. And that, you know, this might not be usable anymore, but it's good. You don't want to get the insulation up under there. It won't tighten down on the wire. So, ow. Something's poking me. I got to hold on to it. It's that thing on the leg sticking out of the ground deal. I don't know why it's even there. Definitely want to get that tight as you can. Let's see. You gotta kind of hold them the right way to get those to open up. That's where they were closed, and I'm just like, well, how do you do that? I thought I was gonna have to wrap those around those screws. That's the way they used to be, the old ones. And it's always kind of a pain. Now, let me see. Should be good and tight. So yeah, I don't know why there's a bent. Oh, I bet you that's maybe your dummy protector. Well, I don't know why that would really matter. Well, just so that you put it in there. Yeah, I guess so you can't put it in there. I don't know if that's what it is. Oh, maybe it hangs on this right here to keep you from being able to, that wouldn't make any sense. Just guessing here, aren't I? Well, I was thinking it might grab into here somewhere. I don't know. Let's see. One thing you gotta do is get that bent so that you can put it back together. There. Well, there's 3 screws you gotta hit. Be more tricky. Let's see. If I get one kind of started, maybe I can rest the line up. That is smaller than I can even see. I can't tell what I'm doing. I think it might be better if I tried to put them down in their spot. I can see, you know, like I said, get one. Yeah, I better get one started. Gotta get those wires to where they're compliant. Going in the right place, so maybe 2. You better get 2 started at once. It does. I thought it was a easier design to work with, but now I'm starting to question that theory. We'll see. Once you get one in there and you can't see, keep lining the other one up. don't think it goes as far down in there as I expected it was going to. So I think I've got my habit. Sure got tight quick. Oh yeah, it does go down in there further. But you, this tightens down. That's what I like about it, is this tightens down so that you get good strain relief. See if any of these other tips grab better. That one doesn't. Yeah, that one does grab it better. I don't want to overdo it. This one's got a lot of torque to it. I don't want to break it. It's just plastic. I don't want to make sure I have it together. Okay, yeah. Looks like it's in there even. Yeah. Okay, so now I could push that back a little bit if I can. Then a strain relief will perhaps hold it in the right place. There. I do like that strain relief on it. That's probably the reason I bought it. I was getting real hungry earlier. And I didn't want to stop and just eat a whole meal. I wanted to get this finished. So I ate a piece of cake. Let them eat cake. You know what they said, the queen said? Some queen of somewhere in England, some point in time. Marie Antoinette. Marie. You see that piece of insulation? This can be good to save. Sometimes you need to slide some big piece of insulation over something. Okay, so I believe I got it. Well, yeah, at least I was somewhere in the general area. I was looking to see how bad I did on the placing it in front of the camera. Yeah, it's all right. It's even. Okay, now. I started to say I got my multimeter sitting here, and I started to say I would try to test, you know, for open circuits, but my little, I don't have any, I need to get a kit of add-ons, because my little pointers, they're real sharp, and they'll get you, but they're not long, which is good, because you can't accidentally short things out. My old meter, my old realistic meter, analog meter, I blew up two power supplies trying to mess around, work on them, computer power supplies, testing them, just because their leads are so long. But anyway, you can't, they won't go in there and touch anything. So, but I can plug this in up here, and that's what I've got handy to plug in, though. It's got such a long cable it won't really set anywhere too well. Move my magnifying glass before I get mess it up. Now, what can I plug in? I don't know. Looking at my, here we go. Okay, a battery charger will probably do for my drill. It's already, oh, I've got it blocked by this. Whoops, turn the power off. Get my light. Okay, stuff can be hard to get loose. Got another power strip up there where that's plugged in. What are we doing? It's about to yank it. And it's about to get yanked down from there, too, by this cord. So I didn't have that planned out. My demonstration wasn't planned out, so I didn't know what the heck I was doing there, did I? Okay. Put this in. There we go. we have light. We did for a second. There. I guess it only comes on for a second until you have something plugged in. There we go. Okay, let's see. I can't seem to get it to where to be seen by the camera. Yeah, there we go. Okay, so we got a good power supply, or six way. My battery's been sitting there for a long time, a couple of weeks at least, a week or two. So it needs to be redone anyway, so I don't mind that I did that to it. I just threw that on the floor. That was not really the nicest thing to do to it, was it? I'll plug it back in one more time. Where's my charger thing? There it is. Okay, now, that switch is not the sturdiest of switches, but it doesn't get touched, it just stays in the, it just stays plugged in, doesn't really get messed with, so, there it is, no sense in making any more video, I'm just gonna pick up my mess and go put that thing in and get me some lunch. All right.